leader of the Nationals, Michael McLaughlin. Mr. Mayor, and Ash, particularly you, thank you very much for asking me to be here this evening. And ladies and gentlemen, you are all distinguished guests, and it really is a privilege, I think, as somebody said, to be here this evening. Michael, I think, will agree with me that one of the great things about our job in our role as parliamentarians is the time we spend in regional communities coming across people who have an incredible vision for the future of regional Australia. And Ash is one of those people. When I met Ash, I was just struck by his absolute focus and dedication to make this work, because he saw it as such a great tool to deliver the health services in areas where so often they are simply unable to be delivered. And while we all want to, in a perfect world, we would all love to have medicos on our main streets right across regional Australia, it's often not possible. And I think people would say they would love to be able to have that face-to-face contact, but we have to recognise the limitations of where that isn't possible. And that's where what Ash is putting forward with TMA just fills that vital role of being able to reach out into those communities and deliver those healthcare services that are so needed. About 11 years ago, John Anderson, the former leader of the Nationals and Deputy Prime Minister, did a headland speech, and it was called Two Nations or One. And he was focused on the divide that existed between city and country, the have of the city, the have not of the country, the fact that we almost have two different social levels and economic levels, this real gap between what people in the cities have in terms of service provision and a whole range of areas, and people in the country. And 11 years later, not a lot has changed. And it's going to take visionary thinking from people like Ash and the team here to start bridging that divide. And people who live in regional communities, they don't necessarily want a heart surgeon on their corner. They just want a reasonably comparative level of healthcare to those who live in the cities. And that's where I think TMA has such an incredible opportunity to bridge that divide between city and country when it comes to delivery of healthcare. And it's really important that we do that, because in our roles as parliamentarians, and I guess this is another, I suppose, piece of the picture for how this is all delivered, is how do we fit in? And it's really important that in our roles, we try and look for those things that are going to make a difference, and then what it is that we can do to be part of that, to support that. And even in just a small way, from talking to Ash, it became very obvious that this type of technology and health delivery is ahead of the system. The Medicare schedule fees simply aren't compatible in a number of areas with what this is actually providing. So from a political sense, to be aware of that is really important, because there has to be the whole picture for this to go forward in a complete way, and we need to know that the system is actually keeping up with the very revolutionary steps forward that this is taking in the terms of health provision. And it's interesting to see the new age, I think this is. It was so interesting seeing the picture of that newspaper from 1924, that was just extraordinary. But it really is new age technology and looking into the future for how things are going to work. I have responsibility for the Coalition for Regional Education, and only on Wednesday I was up at Central Queensland University, CQ University, they call it now, up at Rockhampton. And they were talking to me almost exactly the same way, logistically, as we're talking about health here, about education. About, they try to provide it, they've got 12 campuses, a number of those in the regions, most of them in the regions, where they're delivering education. And yet there are just those communities where they don't have the economies of scale. And they're now delivering into those communities a terrific model where they're doing it by telecommunication, doing it by video conferencing. They're having a node, a module, if you like, out in these smaller communities. And it's actually giving economy of scale to be able to deliver that. And those students in those areas, whereas before they were just disparate and doing it just online individually, they can actually collectively come together. and have this delivered by this fabulous new telecommunication that they're doing online. So it's that real collective of distance, but finding ways to get that collective in one place and deliver this type of thing to education through similar, nowhere near as advanced as this, but that similar principle of technology. I think it's really important that we recognise there is going to be such a place for the technological delivery of different things out in regional communities, and work with that and make sure that it delivers what we need it to out in the regional communities. Without, of course, risking the fabric of those communities, because we do need to have whole pictures of communities. We need professionals right across the board, where we can get them, as much as we can get them, absolutely. But things such as TMA are going to provide, we're having a lot of struggle getting professionals across all the spectrums out into regions, and often that is because there isn't the healthcare that particular family might want in a regional community. There isn't the social structure in that regional community. So, and there's a whole range of things, so it becomes a big picture. So if we're trying to encourage a professional, you know, perhaps of another nature entirely, it might be a legal person or a person in the education field going to a small town that they know has this type of facility within that town to enable them to have that connectivity to the health services they need without actually having a practitioner in these small towns where it's just not going to be available. That then means we can actually build stronger communities right across the board, because this is part of the whole jigsaw puzzle of those strong and healthy communities in the regions into the future. So thank you very much for having me here tonight. It's a delight to be involved with this, it truly is, and as I do echo those comments again, it is a real privilege to be involved with this, and very sincere congratulations to you, Ash, and all of your team, and offer you the support you need.